Right now he's sitting in 10th place, first after the first two events. But the last workout last night kind of got him a little bit. Kind of saw a few holes in the technique of his rope climb that we need to fix, which kind of fatigues his arms too much. And that kind of wore him out a little bit for that workout. So he came in just under 7, dropped him to 10th. But this workout's a good one. I'd like to see it dominated by a former collegiate sprinter.
Yeah, there you go. How does he feel? Like, you know, does he feel beat up or anything?
No, he actually feels fresh. He's got a couple blisters on his fingers from the rope climb, but other than that, he's feeling pretty good. A little tight, but no significant soreness or anything.
Yeah. Up to this point, is there anything you can do to help, or what do you do at this point?
At this point, it's just helping his mindset. Yeah. Kind of talking about the workouts, how we're going to approach it. He's a guy that wants to go out there and just do the work, but kind of reining him in, talking about where we need to pick up time, where we need to be consistent on reps and be efficient on reps is where I'm at right now.
What is his expectation for himself, like for this whole thing, you know what I mean?
His expectation is he wants to win it,
yeah.
And that's why he's trained so hard for it. You know, he wanted to get back to the games, he missed it last year, and leading up to it, we saw, hey, you have a really good chance to make it anyway, you're doing quite well, so let's just make our goal to win it all.
Yeah.
So he's focused on that, he's good to go this morning. My background is I have a 4-year degree in sports medicine. I worked with high school athletes, collegiate athletes for my entire career leading up into CrossFit. So I've worked with high-level state champions, high-level national champions, All-Americans and soccer. So I've been around high-level athletes my entire life, my entire career. So, and I was actually a collegiate baseball player. I was an All-American and did those sports. So being a part of this is just a kind of a natural rollover into what I've done my entire life. So I feel very at home here. And it just kind of helps play into Dan. We actually grew up like 5 miles from each other and never knew it. So it's kind of cool that we know all the same people and know all the same stores and shop at all the same places. And it's kind of cool. But it's just part of what I've been doing my entire career. So it's been fun to be a part of that leading up to CrossFit because it's been such a great meshing between the two.
Yeah.
You know, you're training people who haven't done this stuff before, or you're training world-class athletes in the sport of fitness, and they're all working together and getting stronger.
At the high-level stuff, in terms of just that, are there differences between CrossFit and whatever and other sports and things like that, or is it just kind of, do you know what I mean? Like, what are the differences in terms of high-level coaching?
In high-level coaching, you look at some sports, everything's defined. Football field, soccer field, everything's defined. You're within boundaries. There's a certain number of players. You know what's going to happen in a game. You know what passes. You know your plays. And CrossFit is totally different. So the mental approach is somewhat, it's a different approach. You have to be ready for everything. Whereas in, say, a soccer game or a football game, you know your opponent. You have film. You have tape. You know what's coming at you. You know how to approach it. You know, we come in this morning, we don't know what we're going to see. We know we're going to be on a track. You know there's a rig still up, so there may be runs, there may be rings, there may be GHDs. We had no idea, but his body has to physically be ready for it. And then we have to know, coming into it, okay, how many reps can he go unbroken? What's it going to be like pulling from somewhat of a deficit? How are his hamstrings going to feel? You know, those sort of things come into play. I think the dynamics of what we do in CrossFit at a high level are significantly more strenuous and significantly higher than your typical high-level sports. Because their parameters are defined, ours are defined, but there's 1,000 different parameters we have to be ready for.
Are you the type of coach that gets nervous and stressed out and stuff like that watching the events, or you know, how do you feel when you watch Dan out there?
When I'm out there, I'm watching everything. I'm critiquing his movement. I'm like, oh, I gotta fix that hole in his technique, or we gotta get better here. But I'm not too stressed. I'm pretty relaxed. I've always been that way in sports. I'm nervous leading up to the event, but when it happens, I'm watching him and I'm watching the other guys to see where he's at, and I'm watching his body language to tell me how he's feeling. Last night I could tell he was just tired. He's not going to do well even after the first. But he did well, but I knew he wasn't going to be like, you know, sub 5 time just based on how he was in the first two rounds, because I could see the fatigue in his body. It'll be interesting to see how he's doing today. I haven't seen him warm up yet, but I know he's starting to get ready.
Dan is in 5th place with the outside chance of hitting the podium.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's exciting.
How does he feel?
He looks good. He's focused. I talked to him back at the regional competition, and he at that point it was kind of given he was going to be making the games, and he's like, man, I don't know if I want to just go out there and just kind of coast through the workout, or I said, no, you're not. I said, you're going to go out there and send a message, and he did that in the last workout. So right before he went out there, I said, listen, remember that last regional walk? I said, you had a message to send, and you need to go do that again, because if you want to get up on that podium, you need to channel that same intensity to get up there. So it's exciting. He's focused, he's relaxed, he's smiling, laughing with the guys, but he wants to get out there and do some work. I can see it in his face.
I'm not saying this is going to happen, but if for whatever reason he didn't get up on the podium, how do you think he would feel?
He's excited. His goal was to get to the games, and my goal was him to be on the top. And he's here now. He has a chance of getting on the podium and doing well. I think it's been a great success so far this season, and it's going to continue for him. So it's fun to watch.
How will you feel? Do you get some personal satisfaction out of when you have an athlete that does well? Even though you're not doing anything. Yeah. Technically, but how does it make you feel personally?
I'm excited to help them. I'm excited to help them achieve what they want. So it excites me to kind of see him reach his goals. It's cool for him to be up there, and it's awesome. And I'm glad to be a part of that. I told him, I said, it's an honor to be part of your training and be part of what you're doing here in CrossFit. So I thanked him for that, because satisfaction comes from helping him achieve what he wants to do.